so brilliant.
It is superb.
That's in the air.
Oh, it is caught too. It's a super catch.
There were times when you would doubt yourself and people would doubt you, and it was a lot harder for the Asian community to break through into the system. But growing up, I knew I had to be, you know, a lot better than the rest. It wasn't just a thing of having fun. It was a thing of actually developing and knowing that if I come here and put the hard work in, things will definitely get a lot better.
Listerpack, grew up here with my brothers and dad as well. Used to play a cricket ball in these nets. Years ago, I used to, you know, run around the park. Dad made us run around the park as well.
You know, you'd be there pushing us initially to start with, making sure, you know, you get your runs in, you get your fitness in, you have to, it's compulsory, you need to. You know, it's all, you know, good playing, you know, batting and bowling, but if you're not really, you know, fit enough to play cricket in that sense, then, you know, you need to work hard.
Me, my two brothers and my dad, we all used to play one team together back, I don't know how many years ago that must have been, when I was probably 8, 9, 10. And then my dad just threw me the ball and got me into leg spin. So it was my dad, you know, who first started off, you know, for me playing cricket, leg spin and batting as well.
He always probably had a dream of me, you know, playing for England, playing, you know, probably, you know, representing Yorkshire first, and obviously England came along. So for him, it was, you know, he sacrificed probably all his, you know, all his life or whatever to get me where I am today. So, you know, a lot of, you know, big thanks goes to him for, you know, for everything that he's, you know, given me. So, you know, whatever my dad passed on to me, I'll do the same thing, you know, hopefully with my little ones, you know, as they grow up, giving them the opportunity as well that, you know, my father gave me.
That attempt at a long and serious innings is over, courtesy of Adil Rashid.
Well, this is exactly why Rashid is so important to this one-day team, because he can do this, he can get the best players in the world out.
You know, there were times growing up and you would doubt yourself and people would doubt you, knowing that, you know, you're not going to make it. It's hard to get through the Yorkshire system, especially, you know, knowing their history or whatever it is. A lot of people said it's tough work, it's hard work. So growing up, personally, me, I knew I had to be a lot better than the rest. So my father knew that as well. So he would push me in that sense, making sure, you know, you can't, you know, if you've got to train, you've got to train harder than everybody. You've got to make sure you're better than everybody, because of the system and how things worked back then. It was harder for the Asian community to break through into that system. But, you know, thankfully, thank God, and, you know, my father, whatever, they really give me that support, really push me towards, you know, making sure that I am, you know, fully ready. So as a result, when I played for under 11s, 13s and 15s, I did okay, I did fairly well, and it pushed through towards the professional level.
Well, Adil Rashid is a very good young, talented leg spinner. A young lad, plenty of promise. Now, Adil Rashid. Oh dear, that's a wide, has to be.
Big hit from Ponting, has he got all of it? Yes, he has. There he goes again, and is that even better? It's majestic.
Rashid bowled brilliantly at the Oval, then they left him out for two matches. His confidence is gone.
There was a period probably between 2010 and 12 where I was struggling in cricket. Right, I was struggling in cricket, I wasn't doing well or whatever, and in life in general I was a bit wayward or whatever it was. And, you know, I really sat down and thought to myself, I really need to, saw my cricket out as well. So I made a bit of a U-turn towards, like I said, I need to go back towards, you know, to my religion. That's right, I need to start praying. I need to start, you know, doing the things that, as what Muslims do, be, you know, give charity and do this and be a good person and, you know, change the whole way of my life. And that's what I did. And just by chance, everything else, my life started turning around. Like I said, you got married, you get kids, and cricket starts going on an incline, and everything else started falling into place, you see. Ultimately, religion really gets me on a different level spiritually and as a person.
He's in the side, he's been picked. Adil Rashid is going to bowl. Can he perform here for England? That's the question.
All right, that was good. That's in the air. That might be caught.
Oh, it is caught too. Adil Rashid has a wicket.
Well, that might be close. Yes, four now for Adil Rashid.
And that is 50 for Adil Rashid. It means so, so much to him. Lovely innings. The story really is Adil Rashid.
As a British Muslim, you know, representing England, you know, it means a lot to me, especially from where I grew up and to where I am now, you know, all the hurdles that I had to overcome, you know, personally for myself, cricketing point of view, and also, you know, as a Muslim I am, you know, the hurdles I had to come across there. As time's gone on, I feel as though I have become more of a role model, especially representing England, and a lot of now kids coming through playing cricket as well, you know, they look up to the likes of myself and Amoy and Ali, who are representing England. You know, it's a happy moment for us, knowing that there are kids out there looking up to us, knowing that there is hope for them as well to, you know, play international cricket or play cricket for, you know, their counties, wherever it is. So hopefully, like I say, me and Mo can still be like inspiration for a long time coming. Let's see you wrong then. What are you gonna make him do? Game driving? Perfect. Oh, good effort. Good effort. Have you got a wrong end? You have got a wrong end. Let's get him through the gate. Let's go through the gate here. It's nice, that. Yeah, you keep working. Oh, well balled. Nice, lads. How are we getting him out? Look to it. Okay, I'll tell you. Try getting balled. Both of you try getting balled. He looks like a good player. So you've got to get him bowled. How are you going to get him bowled? Have the mindset when you're bowling. So if you're going to pitch your leg, imagine that hitting off. So imagine that and then try to do it. That was hitting middle and off. Keep repeating that, repeat, repeat, repeat. Keep having that same mindset. Well, bowled. And if you bowl it short, it doesn't matter. You bowl it short, don't, you know? And if you bowl it full, it doesn't matter. It's practice, nobody's perfect. We're all going to bowl bad balls, good balls. But you've got to enjoy what you're doing. If you don't enjoy it, and just it's gonna be tough work. So you gotta enjoy it. And if you bowl a bad ball, it doesn't matter.
If you look looking back at it, probably 10, 15 years ago, I wouldn't have imagined I would have been where I'm in this position today. It's something like you don't really think that could happen, you know, playing for England, especially, you know, at the highest level. It happens, everything happens for a reason, and good journey so far. You know, hopefully it'll continue for a lot longer.
Brilliant cricket.